Ignatius, who is also called Theophorus, to the church which has obtained mercy through the majesty of the Most High Father, and Jesus Christ, his only begotten Son, the church which is beloved and enlightened by the will of him that wills all things which are according to the love of Jesus Christ, our God, which also presides in the place of the report of the Romans, worthy of God, worthy of honor, worthy of the highest happiness, worthy of praise, worthy of obtaining her every desire, worthy of being deemed holy, and which presides over love, is named from Christ and from the Father, which I also salute in the name of Jesus Christ, the Son of the Father, to those who are united both according to the flesh and spirit, to every one of his commandments, who are filled inseparably with the grace of God, and are purified from every strange stain. I wish abundance of happiness unblameably in Jesus Christ, our God. Through prayer to God, I have obtained the privilege of seeing your most worthy faces, and have even been granted more than I requested. For I hope as a prisoner in Christ Jesus to salute you, if indeed it be the will of God, that I be thought worthy of attaining to the end. For the beginning has been well ordered, if I may obtain grace to cling to my lot without hindrance to the end. For I am afraid of your love, for fear that it should cause me injury. For it is easy for you to accomplish what you please, but it is difficult for me to attain to God if you spare me. But it is difficult for me to attain to God if you do not spare me, under the pretense of carnal affection. For it is not my desire to act towards you as a human pleaser, but as pleasing God, even as also you please him. For neither shall I ever have such another opportunity of attaining to God, nor will you, if you shall now be silent, ever be entitled to the honor of a better work. For, if you are silent concerning me, I shall become God's. But if you show your love to my flesh, I shall again have to run my race. Pray then, do not seek to confer any greater favor upon me than that I be sacrificed to God while the altar is still prepared, that being gathered together in love, you may sing praise to the Father through Christ Jesus, that God has deemed me, the Bishop of Syria, worthy to be sent for from the east to the west. It is good to set from the world to God, that I may rise again to him. You have never envied anyone. You have taught others. Now I desire that those things may be confirmed by your conduct, which is, in your instructions, you enjoin on others. Only request in my behalf both inward and outward strength, that I may not only speak, but truly will, so that I may not merely be called a Christian, but really found to be one. For if I be truly found a Christian, I may also be called one, and be then deemed faithful, when I shall no longer appear to the world. Nothing visible is eternal, for the things which are seen are temporal, but the things which are not seen are eternal. The Christian is not the result of persuasion, but of power. When he is hated by the world, he is beloved of God. For says the scripture, if you were of this world, the world would love its own. But now you are not of the world, but I have chosen you out of it. Continue in fellowship with me. I write to all the churches and impress on them all that I shall willingly die for God, unless you hinder me. I beseech of you not to show an unreasonable goodwill towards me. Suffer me to become food for the wild beasts, through those who instrumentally it will be granted me to attain to God. I am the weed of God, and am ground by the teeth of the wild beasts, that I may be found the pure bread of God. Rather entice the wild beasts, that they may become my tomb, and may leave nothing of my body, so that when I have fallen asleep in death, I may not be found troublesome to anyone. Then shall I be a true disciple of Jesus Christ, when the world shall not see so much as my body. Entreat the Lord for me, that by these instruments I may be found a sacrifice to God. I do not, as Peter and Paul, issue commandments to you. They were apostles of Jesus Christ, but I am the very least of believers. They were free as the servants of God, while I am, even until now, a servant. But when I suffer, I shall be the freed man of Jesus Christ, and shall rise again, emancipated in him. And now being in bonds for him, I learn not to desire anything worldly or vain. From Syria, even to Rome, I fight with beasts, both by land and sea, both by night and day, being bound to 10 leopards, a band of soldiers, who, even when they receive benefits, show themselves all the worse. But I am the more instructed by their injuries to act as a disciple of Christ. Yet am I not thereby justified? May I enjoy the wild beasts that are prepared for me, and I pray that they may be found eager to rush upon me, which also I will entice to devour me speedily, and not deal with me as with some, whom, out of fear, they have not touched. But if they be unwilling to assail me, I will compel them to do so. Pardon me in this, I know what is for my benefit. Now I begin to be a disciple, and let no one of things visible or invisible envy me that I should attain to Jesus Christ. Let fire and the cross, let the crowds of wild beasts, let tearings, breakings, dislocations of bones, let cutting off of members, let shatterings of the whole body, and let all the dreadful torments of the devil come upon me. Only let me attain to Jesus Christ. All the pleasures of the world and all the kingdoms of this earth shall profit me nothing. It is better for me to die in behalf of Jesus Christ than to reign over all the ends of the earth. For what shall a man be profited if he gain the whole world but lose his own soul? Him I seek who died for us. Him I desire who rose again for our sake. This is the gain which is laid up for me. Pardon me, brethren. Do not hinder me from living. Do not wish to keep me in a state of death. And while I desire to belong to God, do not give me over to the world. Suffer me to obtain pure light. When I have gone there, I shall indeed be a man of God. Permit me to be an imitator of the passion of my God. If anyone has him within himself, let him consider what I desire, and let him have sympathy with me, as knowing how I am straitened. The prince of this world would fain carry me away and corrupt my disposition towards God. Let none of you, therefore, who are in Rome, help him. Rather be on my side, that is, on the side of God. Do not speak of Jesus Christ, and yet set your desires on the world. Let not envy find a dwelling place among you, nor even should I, when present with you, exhort you to it. Be you persuaded to listen to me, but rather give credit to those things which I now write to you. For though I am alive while I write to you, yet I am eager to die. My love has been crucified, and there is no fire in me desiring to be fed. But there is within me a water that lives and speaks, saying to me inwardly, Come to the Father. I have no delight in corruptible food, nor in the pleasures of this life. I desire the bread of God, the heavenly bread, the bread of life, which is the flesh of Jesus Christ, the Son of God, who became afterwards of the seed of David and Abraham. I desire the drink of God, namely his blood, which is incorruptible, love, and eternal life. I no longer wish to live after the manner of men, and my desire shall be fulfilled if you consent. Be willing, then, that you also may have your desires fulfilled. I entreat you in this brief letter, do give credit to me. Jesus Christ will reveal these things to you, so that you shall know that I speak truly. He is the mouth altogether, free from falsehood, by which the Father has truly spoken. Pray for me, that I may attain the object of my desire. I have not written to you according to the flesh, but according to the will of God. If I shall suffer, you have wished well to me. But if I am rejected, you have hated me. Remember in your prayers the church in Syria, which now has God for its shepherd, instead of me. Jesus Christ alone will oversee it, and your love will also regard it. But as for me, I am ashamed to be counted one of them. For indeed, I am not worthy, as being the very last of them, and one born out of due time. But I have obtained mercy to be somebody, if I shall attain to God. My spirit salutes you, and the love of the churches that have received me in the name of Jesus Christ, and not as a mere passerby. For even those churches which were not near to me in the way, according to the flesh, have gone before me, city by city, to meet me. Now I write these things to you from Smyrna by the Ephesians, who are deservedly most happy. There is also with me, along with many others, Crocus, one dearly beloved by me, as to those who have gone before me from Syria to Rome for the glory of God. I believe that you are acquainted with them. To whom, then, do you make known that I am at hand? For they are all worthy, both of God and of you, and it is becoming that you should refresh them in all things. I have written these things to you on the day before the 9th of the Kaleds of September. Fare you well to the end, in the patience of Jesus Christ. Amen.